After a year of empty stadiums and supporting our teams from afar, we've all been reminded of the togetherness, inclusivity, and the sheer joy that our nation's game inspires. And it's those values which we'll celebrate over the next couple of days, right here at St George's Park. Welcome along to the FA Disability Cup.
West Brom and Aspire have had some great battles over the years. Me and John have had some great battles over the years. Hopefully another one's on the cards today. I think we've been battling against each other for over 10 years now in the National League and teammates for England. So John's very good technically, probably one of the best in the world. And I like to think I've got a bit of a football brain. So hopefully
tactical.
Yeah, tactics versus technique today, and hopefully the tactics come out on top. We're good friends off the pitch, but on the pitch we're rivals, enemies, yeah. Hopefully we can put on a show and showcase what power chair football is all about. West Brom are coming home with the trophy today, so that's all that matters. Have a good one.
And so we go into penalties. No goals. Who holds their nerve now? First one here for John Boldy, England's captain, with Aspire's first kick of the shootout. Saved by his international colleague, Chris Gordon.
Obviously, gutted with the result, Larkin, obviously I didn't set a good example missing the first one.
Gordon, from the spot, scores! Advantage West Bromwich Albion.
It's a start of hopefully many televised appearances. It's nice to win, first one off the back, live on TV. We've got bragging rights till the next time now, so all good.
Chris Gordon, hands on the trophy, kisses the trophy. West Brom lift the FA Disability Cup for power chair football for the second time. And this, for the Baggies, means absolutely everything.
So just about to head out onto the pitch, ready for kickoff in this one. It is the Cerebral Palsy final between North East Yorkshire and the Cerebral Palsy North West team.
My wife's pregnant, she was due yesterday. I was thinking about her all the time, but I just asked her, she's all right, she's fine. Hopefully this week she'll come.
Just bring you up to speed on how the two teams got here again. They've not played competitively for 18 months or so, but North West, 2019 season, the winners of the National League, and North East qualified through winning the CP Cup.
Oh, the ball across for Osborne! And there is the first goal! The best player so far, Cameron Osborne! Lewis Tupman sets up the shot here. It's Roberts, opens up for the shot deflection. Tupman is there! And from 2-0 down, North West are level at 2-2, and that is why they're the holders. Here's McKechnie. Oh, the breakaway here. Osborne will chase. His goalkeeper's come a long way. The goal is open if you can find the target here. It's Osborne to wrap it up. And he has done exactly that for North East in Yorkshire. Simon Keeney's team take the trophy in the FA Disability Cup.
Full team's buzzing. What a day. What a day. Buzzing. Cheers. Nice one.
Well played to Yorkshire, you know, they got the win and they played very well. I had that in my mind a little bit, but at the end of the day I wanted to get the win for the lads as well, so that's why I'm here as well, but it just wasn't meant to be today.
Northeastern Yorkshire winners of the Cerebral Palsy final in the FA Disability Cup for 2021.
The last of our finals today for the partially sighted final now.
Northwest Scorpions won the last final 9-4 versus Birmingham Futsal. 2018 winners, this is being classed as the decider.
It's taken short here to John McDougall. Chance and the first final goal scored by Nick Acton here for Birmingham. Ball nicked here, but not for long. The attack led by Acton helped on now to McDonald, who makes it 2-0. And the former Scorpions player has Birmingham 2 goals clear, and Birmingham have won the partially sighted FA Disability Cup for the second time. They've beaten the holders as the weekend's theme continues.
Come on, Birmingham!
And that says that Birmingham Futsal for the second time are winners of the partially sighted FA Disability Cup. A superb performance, and they have the trophy.
Was in.
Shattered.
Fantastic. Brilliant.
Well, what a day it was yesterday, and we have two more finals to look forward to today. It's the amputee final live on BT Sport between Peterborough and Portsmouth.
I served with the 1st Battalion Grenadier Guards for 10 years. I'd been on operational tours to Bosnia, Iraq, Afghanistan. And then in 2011, while we were training in Canada to go back out to Afghanistan, I was unfortunately shot on a platoon attack, live firing range for a wall. So I took 6 gunshots to my right leg and 1 to my shoulder. And unfortunately, obviously the shots to my leg hit my femoral artery, which meant I had to have my leg amputated. And then obviously as a result, I ended up being medically discharged from the forces.
And so Pompey get the amputee final in motion.
Since then, I've been trying to find my sort of place, and obviously football was my love growing up. You know, I played it from the age of 7 all the way up to joining the military, and then I was fortunate I still got to play in the forces. And then I never thought I'd get the opportunity to play again, and certainly didn't think I'd get the opportunity to play in occasions like this.
I lost my leg when I was 14. Obviously, as a kid growing up, you always dream of playing football, and that's what a lot of boys want to be as a footballer when they grow up. So, I thought that part was over of my life, but it's a really good honour to be here today. I've played here before with Portsmouth 2 seasons ago, but we got beat 2-1 by Everton, so looking to get some redemption today.
After the forces, I'd initially gone into competing in bodybuilding and then into strongman, so I competed in strongman for 4 years before this. And then I suppose, like most veterans, it all caught up with me and I hit that real sort of low point. And I think the thing that was sort of highlighted whilst I was having counselling and so on was my need to be back around people, socialising, being part of a group of people. I'm never satisfied, I'm always trying to sort of improve myself, and the icing on the cake would be to win the fixture today, and I think we're more than capable.
Here comes Mark Smith for Peterborough. That is it in terms of extra time. And we will go to a penalty competition now to settle the amputee football in the FA Disability Cup.
It's been absolutely fantastic so far. You're watching these guys now, like the power they have. Even though I don't want to get kicked in the head, I'm worried I'm behind the goal. The power they have in their one leg is incredible, and it's just seeing all these different amazing things that these people can do. You know, actually, we have so much power, and I've loved being here this weekend, seeing that, and the rivalries as well. Such strong rivalries that the world needs to know about, because they are fierce.
Well, former Pompey captain Roger Whitehouse is next on the block. Whitehouse, oh, and saved by Kieran Lambourne, and the push are on the brink of victory. Harry Ash, the Peterborough captain, it is over to you. The man with the armband, the chance to win the trophy. Harry Ash has won the trophy, and for the third time, Peterborough United are amputee football winners at the FA Disability Cup.
Scenes on the pitch, absolutely jubilant.
And for the third time, it is Peterborough United winners of amputee football in the FA Disability Cup. Peterborough have the cup in their hands. What a day for them. We are now outside for the last of the 5 finals, the blind final here. It's perhaps the showpiece, this, a sport which people say simply blows you away when witnessed for the first time. 2 enormous rivals in RNC Hereford against Merseyside Blind here. 27 degrees we are. It's going to be a really, really hot afternoon for these players.
It's been absolutely brilliant. I mean, it's so hot today. I'm sweating. It's so warm out here. The standard has been so ridiculously high. It's been phenomenal.
This now is Robin Williams. Oh, and the ball breaks off the goalkeeper. Great chance. Williams has found the final's first goal for Merseyside. And the holders steal the initiative in the blind final. It's English again. He loves to run from these positions, dribbling the ball as he goes. English, it's a marvellous run, and that is an excellent goal. Oh, Dan English delivers one of the moments of this weekend's competition.
This match will now go to a penalty shootout.
Captain Owen Bainbridge, former England captain for the blind team, can settle this. He can really feel the tension.
Yeah, okay. Right post. Yeah, a little bit more. Yeah, perfect. A little bit more forward. Yeah.
The pressure. Breach and RNC Hereford are winners in the Blind Football, the FA Disability Cup. The trophy is theirs.
When I was a kid, I could never have imagined anything like this. But it's just been a phenomenal weekend for disabled football. It's given me the bug though, genuinely, watching the Amputee final earlier, I kind of came away and I said to Jules as we were walking off, I want to go and play again. One more season at Arsenal, hopefully, see if I can get back into it, lose some weight maybe, not drink as much and try and, yeah, get back playing. One last hurrah. And then maybe next season, hopefully I could be here.
It really has been a festival of disability sport. We hope that you've enjoyed watching the FA Disability Cup live on BT Sport. And we truly hope that our national game continues to inspire many. Thanks for your company.